Hey guys, and welcome to Russian Grammar in Sounds, where we look at a certain aspect of Russian grammar by analyzing the lyrics of popular Russian or Soviet songs. And today I chose for you the lines where pronouns «я» and «ты» are used in the genitive or instrumental case, and we will compare them. In the genitive case, it will be «меня», «тебя», and in the instrumental, мной, тобой. Why are we taking these cases together? Because first, they are used with the same preposition с or со. And second, they are used in the same meaning of being nearby. So how to understand the difference between these two? We'll see today, and let's get started. Well, first we will consider the meaning of being near or next to. So, if we see the word около, we always use the genitive case. And if we see the expression рядом с, next to, or рядом со, we use the instrumental case. But what's the difference between с and со when we use either of them? Normally, we use с and so is used with a few exceptions. Normally, it's words that start with two consonants, but not all of them. That's why when you come across this kind of word, just note it and try to memorize. I will give you a few examples. Со мной, with me. Со всеми, with everybody. Со страхом, with fear. But for example, с правдой, with the truth, you use «с». Okay, so let's listen to our examples. Около тебя мир зеленее, около тебя солнце теплее, около тебя. Около тебя мир зеленее, около тебя солнце теплее. This is a famous song by Yolka, a pop singer. So we see this word около, and we know that тебя is in the genitive case, which means next to you, the world is greener. And again, next to you, the sun is warmer. When you see this ее ending in the end of adjectives, you may be sure that it's comparative form, зеленее, like greener, теплее, like warmer. There are also other comparatives with the word более, for example, or exceptions like хорошо, лучше. Yeah, хорошо, good, лучше, better. It's like in English, good, better. We don't say gooder, yeah? So there are exceptions. And the second song. Выглядишь так несовременно рядом со мной. Ты выглядишь так несовременно рядом со мной. It was the famous song by Виктор Цой. Let's get to the words. Ты выглядишь так несовременно рядом со мной. So, ты выглядишь means you look. Я выгляжу, ты выглядишь, она выглядит, они выглядят, мы выглядим. Yeah? For example, она хорошо выглядит. She looks good. Так несовременно. Так means so. Несовременно, literally unmodern or not modern, or old-fashioned. Yeah? Современно is modern, несовременно is old-fashioned. Рядом со мной, so рядом со, indicates the instrumental case, with me. So, you look so old-fashioned next to me. And now we will look at the preposition с or со. When the meaning is from, с, from, for example, when do you use с as from? When talking about the place, you would use на. Например, Я на стадионе. I'm on a stadium. When you are leaving this place, you would say я иду со стадиона. I'm coming from stadium. So, с is related to на. When you use в, talking about being at some place, you use is. Например, я живу в Москве. Я из Москвы. I live in Moscow. I'm from Moscow. But when you say я живу на Таити, I live on Tahiti, on the island, you will say я с Таити. I'm from Tahiti. You see, that's quite easy if you get used to it. В из, на с, or со. So, and when the meaning is with someone, with something, the case is instrumental, not genitive. So, from genitive case, with instrumental case. And now let's get to our sounds. Сегодня начинается с тебя. Сегодня начинается с тебя. Сегодня начинается с тебя. Сегодня means today. Начинается. Starts. Mm-hmm. Today starts, we are thinking, with you or from you. So we know that тебя is the genitive form. It means that today is starting from you. It's like my day starts from thinking about you, for example, yeah? And let's listen to the second example. А может, я с тобой останусь? And maybe I will stay, я останусь, it's the future, с тобой. Here, с means with, because тобой is in the instrumental case. So, and maybe I will stay with you. Maybe I'm gonna stay with you. And I would want to show you one more example. It's a really cheerful Soviet song. I love it. That's why I took it. Когда мои друзья со мной. It means when мои друзья, my friends, друзья is plural, that's why we use мои, my plural. Со мной means with me, instrumental case here. Try to look up this song, it's really, really nice. And we get to prepositions of place. Remember, I told you that with these words, we always use the genitive case when we are talking about something being at some place. Yeah, like in front of, or next to, or others, or being surrounded with something. But there are prepositions that indicate instrumental case. So when you see между, which means in between, над or надо, which means over, под or подо, which means under, above, under, and за, which literally means behind, and перед, which means right in front of. So when you see one of these words, you can be sure that instrumental case follows these words. And let's look at some examples. This song was quite popular, I think, in 2000s. Между мной и тобой остается ветер. Между, instrumental case, between, Me and you. Ветер means the wind. Остается, оставаться means to stay or to remain. So between me and you, the wind remains. And let's listen to Виктор Цой again with the preposition за.
Закрой за мной дверь, я ухожу. Закрой за мной дверь, я ухожу.
Закрой за мной дверь, я ухожу. Закрой. Close. It's imperative, like do it. За мной дверь. За мной literally means behind me. So close the door behind me. I'm leaving. Mm-hmm. And the last example about being over something.
Надо мною тишина, небо полное дождя. Дождь проходит сквозь меня, но боли больше нет.
This was the rock band Aria with Kipelov. And the line goes, надо мною тишина, небо полное дождя. So why is it мною and not мной? Because it's simply the old form of мной, which is used in literature or this kind of songs like ballads, yeah? And надо is like со, not с, but со before мной. So надо мной, we don't say над мной because it's difficult to pronounce. Надо мной, but над тобой. Mm-hmm. So, over me there is silence. You see, the verb is often omitted, like is. Silence is over me. Небо полное дождя. The sky full of rain. Why is it off here? Because дождя is in the genitive case, so we can guess that full of rain. And now let's look at the second line. Дождь проходит сквозь меня, но боли больше нет. So the rain goes or goes by. Проходить, it means to go by, to go through. In this case, it means through, because сквозь is through. The rain goes through me. And here, меня is not in the genitive or instrumental case, it's in the accusative case. Сквозь goes with the accusative case, and it's just я in accusative and genitive are the same. Меня. Mm-hmm. For example, ты видишь меня? Accusative. Or меня нет? Genitive. The rain goes through me, but больше нет. Absence. Больше means anymore. Больше нет. This expression mean anymore. So there is no pain anymore. Pain will be in the genitive case because we have this absence. Боль. Боли. But there is no more pain. And now we will look at the last example with both genitive and instrumental cases. Я с тобой. I'm with you. Instrumental. Я твоя. I'm yours. Твой, твоя. So this is a woman who is singing. Yeah? Я твоя. И для меня не секрет. And for me, для is followed by the genitive case all the time. Для меня, for me, it's not a secret. It's not a secret that без меня тебя тоже нет. That without me, again the genitive, без follows by genitive. Без is followed by genitive. And Без меня тебя тоже нет. So without me, there is absence of you. You see, it sounds complicated, but if we analyze it, it's all clear. I'm with you, I'm yours, and for me, it's not a secret that without me, you don't exist either. And on this romantic note, we are finishing, and we'll see each other in Russian Grammar and Sounds. See you!